So today we are going to solve this problem. That is, given a linked list, we have to split it into k consecutive linked list parts. So there are few conditions given. So first condition is the length of each part should be as equal as possible. No two parts should have a size differing by more than one. Okay, the second condition is the part should be in the order of occurrence in the input list, and parts occurring earlier should always have a size greater than or equal to the parts occurring later. So we have to return a list of all the split linked lists. So that is the problem statement basically. So let's see this problem statement with an example. In this example, we are given a linked list which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is of size 5, and k is given as 3. So we have to split this given linked list into 3 parts. We are splitting like 1 and 2 as 1 part, and 3 and 4 as 1 part, and 5 as 1 part. So let's see whether the conditions are met or not. So condition 1 is the difference between size of elements should not be greater than 1. So here the first element size is 2, and the second split linked list size is 2, and the third one size is 1. Here the difference between 2 and 1 is 1, hence our condition is satisfied. So let us skip to condition 2. Now condition 2 is like greater element should come first. So here we already split like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. This 5 is the smaller element which is coming after the split of the greater elements. So second condition is also satisfied. So this is the basic problem statement. So let us deduce the algorithm on how to solve this problem, and then we will work towards the code. Here we will divide the solving of the code into 3 parts. First, we will count the length of the entire linked list. Second, we will determine the length of each chunk. So whether we have to split it into 4, 4, 3 or 2, 2, 1, we will be determining all the length of each chunks. Okay. And the third part is we will be splitting the linked list. And then we will be returning our split linked list as a list. Here the most important step is second one, that is determining the length of each chunk. Let's discuss how we can determine the length of each chunk. So let us see with an example how we can determine the chunk sizes list. Okay. Suppose if k is equal to 3 is given, we have to divide this linked list into 3 parts. So each should contain 2, 2, 1. If k is equal to 2, the chunk list will be 3, 2. Okay. So how we can achieve this list? So let's see. The length now is 5 and k is equal to 3. So let us divide and take whatever the approximate floor value. So how we can perform the floor value in Python is by using double slash. So 5 double slash 3 is equal to 1. So what we will be doing is let's add 1 to it. So this is the maximum length of the chunk. So as we can see, maximum length of chunk is 2. Okay. Now coming to second example, length is 5 and k is equal to 2. So if we floor this amount, so 5 double slash 2 is equal to 2, let us add 1 to it. And as you can see, this is 3 and this is 2. So we can see the larger chunk size is 3 and larger chunk size is 2. Hence we now know how we can find the length of greater chunk. Now we have to see how many those parts are there. In the first example, there are 2 greater chunks. In the second example, there is 1 greater chunk, that is 3. So now we have to find how many of that greater part chunks are there. So we can determine the number of greater chunks by taking the remainder of 5 and 3 and 5 and 2 respectively. So what we'll be doing is 5% 3, that is 2. Next, 5% 2, that is equal to 1. So here as you can see, there are 2 greater nodes, and here as you can see, there is 1 greater node. So now we have to know how many small chunks are there. since k is the total number of chunks and 2 is the chunks of greater than n. So now 3 minus 2 will be giving us the chunk with smaller length. Okay, here also now k is equal to 2 and the greater chunks are only 1. So 2 minus 1 will give us the number of smaller chunks, that is 1. So here 2 is the only one smaller chunk, and here also 1, that is 1 is our smaller chunk. So in this way we will be reducing our algorithm to find the list of the size of chunks. So finally this is the formula for our chunk size list. So length double slash k plus 1 into length percentage of k plus length double slash k into k minus length percentage of k. So now let us see how to code the solution in Python. So here we'll code our first step, that is finding the length of the list, of the linked list. So what we'll be doing is we'll be declaring two variables, current comma length is equal to root comma 0, while current, so current comma length is equal to current dot next comma length plus 1. So by the end of the loop is reached, we now know the length of the linked list. So second step is to find the size of split linked list. Parts. So to find the size of a split linked list parts, we discussed the formula previously, so that we will be entering. So here we will be declaring two variables, chunk size comma longer chunks is equal to length double slash k and length percentage k respectively. Now we'll store the result of the split linked list parts in result. Okay, now we'll be using chunk size times of chunk size plus 1 to times of longer chunks plus chunk size into size of k minus longer chunks. Now we know the size of each linked list after it has been split. Now we have to split the linked list actually into the respective parts. So this is our third step, split the linked list, print comma current is equal to num comma root for index comma num in enumerate of . So if you don't know about enumerate, I will be providing the link in the description below, you can refer to that. If previous, then u dot next is equal to none. Now we'll be storing the current list of nodes into index the position of result. So next what we'll be doing is we'll be skipping that number of items to reach to the next node split position. Suppose if we have to split into 3, 3, 2, we'll be skipping first 3 because we already stored that in result of index. So next we'll be going to 0 plus 3, that is 4th position. So now we are going into 4th position. So what we will be doing is for I in range of num, in range of number comma current is equal to previous will become current and current will become current dot next. So we are skipping those number of items. Next, after everything is completed, we will return. This should be here. And now we will click on run code. Our solution is accepted. Now click on submit. So it is success. It is faster than 85.85% of the remaining solutions. So that's it for this video, guys. If you like this video, please click on like button and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. As always, please like this video and subscribe to our channel, guys. More interesting updates are coming to this channel very soon.